Hello everyone, I'm Jianxu Chen from the Energy Institute of Cell Science. Here I'm really excited to show the napari plugin that we have been working on for the Allen cell and structure segmenter. So we developed the Allen cell and structure segmenter for 3D intercellular structure segmentation. Our goal is to get the highest quality and the most biologically informative segmentation possible from 3D light microscopy data. And for more information, feel free to check out our allencell.org/segmenter webpage. So here is an example. Say, for example, you take an image, image on a Zeiss spinning disk microscope as the input. A typical threshold-based segment algorithm may provide very poor quality segmentation as shown in the middle. The current version of our segmenter will produce the segmentation as you see on the right from the same input image. So our segmenter is the open source Python package that combines classic image segmentation.
Hey, Jianxu, sorry to interrupt. The audio is a little bit muddy.
Okay.
Can you double check? Maybe it seems like your headset mic might be the one that you might have the wrong mic selected.
Yes, I guess.
Let me try this one. Is that better or is that worse?
I think that's better.
Okay.
It's better for me at least. So.
Okay.
Cool. I see some nods. Awesome. Sorry. So sorry to interrupt.
Yeah. Okay. So here for the classic part of our segmenter it is formulated as a simple three-step workflow. In each step, there are very restricted number of functions to select from and very few parameters to adjust. And when the classic segmentation algorithms are not enough, the iterative deep learning workflow can be used to improve the segmentation accuracy and the robustness. So here we prepare the training data by taking the preliminary result from the classic segmentation workflow, and we curate the result instead of manually directly annotating the ground truth in 3D pixel by pixel. So here you can see an example of lemon neuron segmentation where the classic workflow for interface lemon failed or missed four interface nuclei and failed on the mitotic lemon. And after two rounds of iterative deep learning workflows, the final model will be able to produce very good segmentation results. So here is just a very great overview. So the classic component of our segmenter actually comes with a lookup table, which summarizes all the workflows that we developed for more than 25 different intercellular structures. So users can go to this table and find and pick the images as the most similar morphology to their own data, and then start from the pre-configured workflow there, and then tweak the parameters to make it work on their own data. So the workflows are actually designed in a very modular way, so makes it very easy to use and easy to adjust. So in short, by developing this segmenter napari plugin, we hope to make the robust 3D cell image segmentation provided in our segmenter code more accessible to biologists via a graphic user interface. We believe this matters a lot to a biologist because defining the boundary of cellular structures image with 3D light microscopy is still a big challenge, and the segmenter applies and extends the best method for different types of structures in one package. And this new plugin really provides easy access through an napari user interface. And during the Alpha cohort, we focused on making the classic segmentation workflows accessible and adjustable for users at different at all levels. And also importantly, we want to set a proper foundation for this plugin for extension and maintenance in the future much easier. Okay, now let's do some demo. I have my napari window opened and one image preloaded. So this is the sarcomere in cardiomyocyte, and we want to get some segmentation algorithm to get a good segmentation from it. So here first, we load the plugin And then you select the image, select the channel. So for this one, there might be a couple of different images have similar morphology to this one. I would say I will start with this one, which has the most similar density in terms of the tubular structures. So after you could select workflow, you can see all the functions and all the parameters used. This is a pre-configured workflow, and all the details about the workflow and the function and parameters are in our documentation. Okay, now let's run it. So basically, this is a very simple workflow. You just like taking the input image and do some intensity normalization and smooth it and apply a 3D filament filter. And then we apply a size threshold to remove those small pieces segmented due to the noise. And usually, it may take like 30 seconds or so, depending on the size of your image. Yeah, hopefully this should come up in maybe 5 seconds. So here you can see the progress bar and as it's moving forward. And if you want to understand which parameter is doing what and which function is doing what, you can go to this documentation on the right side. Okay, the segmentation comes out and we can see this, all the intermediate results are saved here. First, we have the intensity normalization and then the smoothing. And hopefully, let me zoom in a little bit. So hopefully by toggle on and off, you can appreciate that this smoothing really like reduce the noise in the background without hurting the actual high frequency signal along your segment, along your structure boundary. So now let's look at the final result. So we want to do some overlay here, magenta. Okay, here. So let's zoom in a little bit. So here, if I look at some area like here, I feel like it may be a little bit over segmenting. It looks a little bit, maybe one pixel thicker than I would expect. So let's try some different parameters. So let's make it to the 0.6 and run it again. So if you're curious about like trying to understand how each function and how each parameter works, and there are all the details are in the documentation. And right now, after I change the parameters, I have to run all, but in our next version, you will be able to tweak each individual function and see the effect like step by step. That will be much more convenient in our next version. okay, so after we are having this result coming out, okay, it's much faster than I expect. Let's overlay them again. Okay, and pull up the previous version and the raw image. So here you can see that the magenta is the old version, the first version, and the cyan is the second version. And we can see that the second version is indeed a little bit slimmer than the first version. So here I'm just trying to show like how we can use this to compare different versions of segmentation and to hopefully find the best version, and then how we validate our result. I'm not talking about like which version is the best or which is the correct version. So regarding how we determine our segmentation target, I highly encourage everyone to check out our segmenter paper on bioarchive. We document how we decide our segmentation target with some careful experiment and thoughts. So here, this is a relatively simple workflow. Let me pull up another quick example to show something different, which has a little bit more steps. So this one, this time I have a multi-channel image where I have the cell membrane channel, the nuclear envelope channel, and the nuclear dye channel, which is very clean. I have to boost it up like this. Okay, so in this case, our target structure target is this nuclear envelope via Lemon D1. So here, this workflow will not work, of course. So let me try to select the channel and then select the workflow. Okay. As you can see, there are more steps here. Let's keep it running and then we can talk through the workflow. So basically the key difference here is after doing the normalization and smoothing, we are applying the filament filter slice by slice at three different set of parameters and then merge them. And we want to use this like filament filter to catch this ring. And then we use this ring to localize each individual object. And then we use the individual object to do a watershed to get the final segmentation of lambda V1. This one may take a few more seconds. As you can see, the result are popping up on the left. Okay, here is the output. Let's put it into cyan and also turn on the structure channel. As we can see, the result is pretty good, except something is missing. As I showed in the presentation, and in this case, when the classic workflow does not really working very good, and in the field, and in our segmenter, our philosophy is that we could use the iterative deep learning workflow to help us improve this. So we don't have that implement yet, but in the future, we do want to have function like this. Say, for example, I just pick up a brush and draw something like here, and then tell my neural network, okay, don't look at these areas and anything outside this mask and use that to train your neural network. Okay, then after a few strokes, I have my training data done. I don't need to do any annotation in 3D. And then after a couple of training iterations, I will have a lemon neural segmentation model that can robustly segment all this lemon with very good accuracy. And before I leave the demo, I want to show this, the last channel here. If I turn this contrast a little bit higher, this one. So as you can see here, because the nature of our data, we have multi-channel data, we have nucleus channel, we also have the nuclear envelope channel. We actually already have a very nice 3D segmentation ground truth for our nuclear segmentation model. So we just take this automatic segmentation algorithm. Also maybe do some annotation like this. After a couple of strokes, you have a nice 3D segmentation ground truth to train your 3D nuclear segmentation model. So basically you can never annotate the nuclei better than the nuclei themselves, right? So this is the really get some really high quality 3D segmentation ground truth. Okay, now back to our slides. The Alpha Cohort is just a start. So in the near future, we really want to improve our first version of Segmenter Napari plugin to a fully functional classic image segmentation workflow ideally by June, hopefully in time for the Napari Hub release. And if time allows, we hope to add more functionalities. And after that, in the phase two, we hope to have more community engagement and continuously improve our segmenter based on user feedback. And more importantly, we will further extend our customizability so that user can easily adjust different functions to add new functions, to drop functions, or even build a workflow from scratch. And eventually, users will be able to share the workflows to others or reuse workflows from others. And hopefully we, as a community together, we could build a community-based lookup table together. So of course, after polishing the classic part of our segmenter, we want to integrate the deep learning part into our Napari plugin to make the full functionality of segmenter into this Napari graphic user interface. Finally, this development effort turned into a really, really big project with a big team that harnessed UX, project management, engineer skills. So I want to deeply thank everyone this year for their extensive contribution over the past 3 months, especially our engineer team and the UX designer in the top row. we couldn't have this segmenter plugin without your dedication and hard work. And also importantly, we got really, really great support from the napari community. We are so thankful for that. And this project becomes a real learning experience for me and for our institute, because we try really hard to find the best way to synergize the R&D algorithm development and software engineering and the biology research with robust and user-friendly 3D microscopy analysis. And finally, we wish to thank the Allen Institute founder, Paul Allen, for his mission, encouragement, and support.